Hi friends, this is Natraj. In other video I was talking about what is MVC, what is difference between MVC1 and MVC2 architectures. If you have a single component playing the roles of view and controller layer, it is called MVC1 architecture. Anyway, we will take separate model components. If you have separate component acting as a view, separate component acting as a controller and separate components acting as what? Model layer. Then it is called what? MVC2 architecture. And listen this video carefully, because most of the people uses this architecture to develop Java based web application. It is industry's de facto standard to develop Java web application. What do you mean by de facto standard? As I convinced earlier, it is not officially announced anywhere. We should follow MVC2 architecture to develop what? Web application. Okay, but everyone happily follows this architecture to develop the application. It's something like this year. Before current Prime Minister, we used to have Manmohan Singh as our Prime Minister. Okay, and you know, we know that he is a dummy prime minister or puppet prime minister. Okay, but still everyone knows he is a prime minister, but our de facto prime minister was what? Sonia Gandhi, because she used to control every activity of what? This governance related activities. So that's the reason she called as de facto prime minister. Not officially announced anywhere, but everyone knows he is what? Our de facto prime minister. Similarly, it is not officially announced you should follow MVC2 architecture for better web application development, but everyone's knowingly unknowingly follows it. And you know that in MVC1 architecture, since we take single component for view and controller layer logics, though there is a clean separation between logics, but we don't have much clean separation between logics. To overcome that problem, they have come up with what? MVC2 architecture. In this MVC2 architecture, there is a possibility of what? Taking separate component for view, separate component for controller, and anyhow separate model components will be there, so that you will get more clean separation between logics. Sir, what is this architecture diagram? The architecture diagram of MVC2 is like this. Here is my browser. Here is my browser. Here is my MVC2 architecture web application. As usually, here I am having what? Database software. So let's take MVC2 architecture based. Yes, here is my what? Database software. Let's see. Here we are having controller servlet. What servlet? Sun controller. Here is my view component. Yeah, within the web application only view component. This is our special component acting as a model. If I use Java class, Java beans, normal classes, special component reside inside the web application. If I use EJB kind of thing, okay, it may be there outside the web application. So if I take Spring with Hibernate kind of thing, yes, again it will reside inside the web application. So whatever it is, here is our what? Servlet, which is called controller. This is my special component, okay, which is called model layer. This is my JSP component. What component? JSP, which I call it as a view. Let's see the flow now. Browser gives request to which component? Web application. As a controller, it will trap and take the request. Number one request. Fine. Here, what logic will be there? As usually, request data gathering logic. Request data gathering logic. Here, form validation logic. It will be having integration logic. Yes, it will be having session management logic. What logic here? Session management logic. Here is the story about it. So, when it comes to special component, it contains what logic here? Business logic. It contains what logic? Persistence logic. It contains middleware services. What all these logics are, I have explained in other video. Please go through them. In the introduction of this architecture, I prepared one video. In that video, I have given clarity about all these things. Fine, boss. That's now. So, by using integration logic, it will talk to one or other model component. Yes. So, this is number 2. Number 2. Talking to this one is what? Number 3. Super. Number 4. Here business logic and persistence logic what? Executes to process the request. If necessary, it will even talk with what? Database software. This is number 5. Special component comes back to what? This. Special component what? Gives result to what? Servlet, nothing but what? Controller. Servlet, nothing but what? Controller. Yeah. So, laser here. Here we have a separate component acting as a view. So, it will pass the control to this. It will pass the control to this. This is number 7. And as I said, JSP, which is acting as a view component, just contains what? Presentation. Just contains what logic? Presentation logic. So, actually, servlet uses rd.forward internally because of that. After processing the result, technically speaking, control goes back to what? Controller servlet. Nice. From there, result goes to browser. This is actually technically speaking. But logically, I can say directly control goes to browser. This is logical flow here. Logical means practically it won't happen. But technically this is right. Technically what this is right? Overall, JSP generated output goes to browser. How? Technically, control goes back to servlet. From servlet it goes to whom? Browser. Why? Generally, controller uses rd.forward to communicate with the JSP. RD means request dispatcher dot forward. When you use request dispatcher dot forward, as everyone knows, okay. Once destination component execute, control comes back to what? Source servlet. From there, response goes to browser. So, this is going to be what? Response. This is going to be response. Here is what is the number? What is the number? Number 9. Fine here. These are the various things. So, let us understand flow one by one. Browser gives initial request. As a controller, servlet takes a request. Number 2. Controller reads data that comes along with the request. Controller reads data that comes what? Along with the request. And using integration logic, it communicates with appropriate special component where business logic is there to process the request. Business logic process the request. It needed, it will take the service and DAO classes support here. So, persistence logic talks to database software if necessary. The output generated by business logic comes back to what? Controller. Comes back to what? Controller. Number 7. Controller passes the result back to whom? View. Passes the result back to whom? View. And here JSP executes the presentation logic. JSP executes what? Presentation logic. Come on here. JSP executes presentation logic. From presentation logic, it passes the info to what? Controller servlet. From controller servlet, finally response goes. from controller servlet, finally what response goes to browser. But JSP format the result that is collected from servlet through presentation logic, then it will send the that output to browser as a web page content. See what is the flow? Browser to servlet, servlet to model, model component to what? Database. From there back to what? Controller. Controller passes the data to JSP in the form of request attributes. Here data is collected and formatted using presentation logic, and after that generated output goes to browser. This is MVC2 architecture. So now no doubt compared to model one architecture, more clean separation of logics. MVC architecture quite better clean separation of logics. So let's try to understand advantages and disadvantages, advantages of this architecture. Since there are multiple layers, there is a clean separation between logics. What is this? Clean separation between logics. Clean separation between logics. Next. The modification done in one layer logics does not affect what? Other layer logics. If you do modification in view layer logic, that does not affect controller. If you do modification in what? Model layer business logic, does not affect what? Controller layers. So the modification done in other layer logics. Yeah, due to this, maintenance and enhancement becomes easy. Maintenance means what? Fixing the bugs. Enhancement what? Adding the new features. So maintenance and enhancement of the project becomes easy. Next, project becomes what? Easy. Next one. Parallel development is possible, so productivity is good. What is this? Parallel development is possible, so the productivity is good. Parallel development is possible, so we can say what? Productivity is good. What is good here? Productivity. Productivity means what? Doing more work in less time. How parallel development is possible, I will talk at the end. It is de facto standard to develop web applications. It is a de facto standard to develop what? Web applications. It is industry's de facto standard to develop what? Web application. Nice. Then what is that? What is another advantage behind this? If we use EaseAB, Spring, Hibernate, okay, to develop model layer logics, certain middleware services can be used as, okay, built-in middleware services. That means there is no need of developing middleware services manually. Security from server you can collect and use it. Spring also gives built-in security. Transaction management, Spring gives built-in transaction management. Take it and use it. So there is no need of separately arranging them. You can happily enjoy the middleware services that are there in what? High-end technologies, cutting-edge technologies, okay, to apply on our applications. These are what? Basic advantages. Interviewer ask one question. If you say parallel development is possible, he will say how you can make parallel development happening. So very simple. The project leader divides the team into two parts. Part 1, web authors, also called presentation tier component developers. Part 2, JW developers or business tier component developers. Business tier component developers. So presentation tier component developer takes the support of servlet, JSP and other presentation tier technology like Ajax, JavaScript, HTML, CSS, and take care of view and controller layer logics. ఓకే, బిజినెస్ టైర్ కాంపోనెంట్ డెవలపర్ ఆర్ జేడబ్ల్యూ డెవలపర్ ఆర్ జావా ఫ్రేమ్వర్క్ డెవలపర్ దే టేక్ ద సపోర్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఓకే స్ప్రింగ్ హైబర్నెట్ జావా క్లాసెస్ ఈజీబి అండ్ ఎక్సెట్రా ఎక్సెట్రా దే డెవలప్ సర్వీస్ క్లాసెస్ డిఏఓ క్లాసెస్ పర్సిస్టెన్స్ లాజిక్ బిజినెస్ లాజిక్ ఓకే బై టేకింగ్ ద సపోర్ట్ ఆఫ్ వేరియస్ టెక్నాలజీస్ సిన్స్ దీస్ టూ పార్టీస్ కెన్ వర్క్ ప్యారలల్లీ ఎయిదర్ బై సిట్టింగ్ ఇన్ సేమ్ కంపెనీ ఆర్ టూ డిఫరెంట్ కంపెనీస్ ఆర్ టూ డిఫరెంట్ బ్రాంచెస్ ఆఫ్ సేమ్ కంపెనీ ఐ కెన్ సే ప్యారలల్ డెవలప్మెంట్ ఈజ్ పాసిబుల్ లెట్ అస్ అస్యూమ్ టుమారో US government has kept restriction. What is the restriction? You cannot give 100% project to India through outsourcing. You have to give only 30-40% project or 50% project to India through outsourcing. We don't allow 100% outsourcing. Let us assume this. Okay? No problem. If they use MVC architecture to develop that application happily, they divide the project into two parts, presentation part and business part. Okay. So they recruit some senior developers in US. They develop business tier development in US branch. Okay, US branch of that company or US location. And they give presentation tier part to India. So both teams okay which are there in same project but they are there in two different locations or two different branches of same company generally in CTS this kind of things will happen in Cognizant technology this kind of things will happen in most of the MNCs this is quite common that's why our Indian employees will go according to US team timings so they go by 1 o'clock and come by night 12:30 1 o'clock like that So both these teams can work parallelly, can develop the logics parallelly. So that's why we can say what parallel development is possible. So what is the advantage of it? Parallel development, fast development, productivity is good. And moreover, for Indian branch employees, they need not to pay high salaries. They can complete entire logics through with what low-end salaries. So due to this project cost will be reduced. Parallel development is possible. All other benefits will be there. So that's the reason we always say MVC is very much known for what developing parallel development. Sir, are there any disadvantages in this entire architecture? Yes, there are disadvantages, but they are not seriously considerable disadvantages. I'm not saying disadvantages are not there, but they are not seriously considered as what disadvantages. It's something like looking for the worst in the best. Everything is fine, but still we are trying to find out problems in that. It's something like this. Rainy season started, rains are coming. All are happy. Why? Farmers can start their cultivation, that means farming kind of thing. And city people will get daily water and they can be happy with the utilization of water because the water is going to supply every day. And so they need not to compromise in daily activities. But one, two people are not happy and we need not to bother much about them. Number one, ice cream parlor owner. Number two, coconut water seller. Because these two people will not be happy because rainy season has come that their business will go down. But we need not to bother much about those people because we have to go by majority people. So that's why you worry more about what advantages, you don't worry much about what disadvantages. Because they are negligible disadvantages, don't worry about it. What are those, sir? For parallel development, multiple programmers are required. For parallel development, multiple programmers are required. Knowledge on multiple technologies is required. Knowledge on multiple technologies is required. I hope you got a clarity on it. Yeah, because you have to learn multiple technology in order to develop this application. I think you got a clarity on it. Fine. So this is about working with what? MVC 2 architecture. Better than model 1, MVC 1 architecture. I hope you benefited with this video. Okay. NATRAZ@gmail.com. Fine. Thank you. Keep smiling and happy coding.